Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about what is dental radiography. So the dental radiography in detail we are going to see. So the dental radiography are of two types. First is intraoral, other is extraoral. When we are talking about the intraoral radiography, there are four different types of radiograph, such as bisecting angle technique we can use parallel technique, we can use bitwin technique, and we can use occlusal radiographs. So there are the four different types of intraoral radiography techniques. Other than that, there are something called as periapical radiography, such as So the periapical radiography describes the intraoral technique designed to show that individual teeth and the tissue under the apex. So it will going to show the teeth and the apex of the root. So the periapical radiography is for showing periapical lesions and the periapical or the apex of the root. So in periapical radiography, the each teeth usually show a 2 to 4 tooth and provide detailed information about the teeth and the surrounding alveolar bone. So now we are going to see parallel angle technique or the bisecting angle technique in detail. As the name is indicating, parallel angle technique, so in which the film placement is parallel to the tooth surface. So as you can see, this is a film, this is an image receptor or the film. So this film is placed parallel to this long axis of the tooth. And this is the direction of X-ray tube. So in parallel angle technique, the X-rays should be parallel to the image receptor or the film. While when we are talking about bisecting angle technique, in which image receptor or film are placed as close as possible to the tooth surface, as you can see here. Here the X-ray tube producing X-rays should be perpendicular to the bisecting line of the long axis of the tooth and the image receptor. As you can see, this green line is nothing but the line bisecting the long axis of the tooth and the image receptor. So here the long axis of the tooth and the image receptor will coincide at a point, and the line from bisecting this two angles, so the X-ray tube or the X-rays should be perpendicular to this imaginary line. So here X-rays should be perpendicular to line bisecting the long axis of tooth and the image receptor. Now let us see what all are the indication of dental radiography. So it can be used for detection of apical infection or the inflammation, and also for assessment of periodontal status, that periapical infection or the periodontal pockets or something like that is there or not. It is also important to assist after trauma that teeth and the associated alveolar bone is fine or not. It is also useful for assessment of presence and position of unerupted teeth. So where is unerupted teeth and on which level is unerupted teeth, it is about to erupt or not. For assessment of all these things, the dental radiography is useful. It is also useful for assessment of root morphology before extraction. So it is also useful for assessment of root morphology, that is that the tooth to be extracted is curved or straight, or there is vertical fracture of the root, whatever the condition is. So for assessment of these kind of morphological variation before the extraction is needed, and for that dental radiography is useful. It is also important during the endodontics to having working length or obturation is correct or not, to assess those things. It is also important for having pre-operative assessment and post-operative assessment of apical surgery. So there is a apicectomy or something like that, so it is happened correctly or not, to assess that. Detailed evolution of apical cyst, is there or not, for that also it is important. And there is periapical lesion or there is something, loss of alveolar bone is there or not. Evolution of implant post-operatively, for assessing that whatever implant we have placed, it is properly in the bone or not. For assessment of implant, it is also important. Now let us see bisecting angle technique in detail. So now let us see rules of this technique. So in bisecting angle technique, we have to take care of different things, such as patient position, film placement is proper or not, horizontal angulation is proper or not, vertical angulation is proper or not, or the point of entry of X-ray beam is proper or not. After all this condition is satisfied, a proper X-ray of the tooth can be achieved. So the patient preparation is very important. So seat the patient and ask them to remove their glasses or any removable appliances. The next thing is patient preparation, in which we have to adjust the headrest to support the head while taking the film. Other thing is that raise or lower the chair to comfortable position or the height for proper operation. So the height of a chair is very important to have a great X-ray. And also we have to take care that place the lead apron and thyroid collar on the patient. We also have to inform the patient about the number of films you will going to take so that they know what to be expected. Like the two teeth is there, like 4-6 or the 3-6. So we have to inform that there will be two radiographs will be taken and the two film will going to be placed in your mouth so that patient will be relaxed for a procedure.